We worship you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
I am grateful. You have been better to me than I've been to myself. You have been good to me. You have been wonderful to me. You have been loving to me. Thank you for the thoughts you have to us. Thoughts of good. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, King of Kings. We worship you. Lord, you are awesome in this place.
Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Are you ready to pray?
Yes, sir.
If there is a man to pray,
it's a God to answer.
Take your Bibles very quickly. Book of Genesis, chapter number 12. We are going to pray. I thank the God of my Father who has brought us together in spite of the counsel of the wicked. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter number 12, just one verse of scripture and then we're going to pray. And the Bible says, now the Lord said in verse number 12, please, verse number 12. The Bible says, and therefore, in go to 10, let's start from verse 10, verse number 10. It says, and there was famine in the land. Please note the word. And Abram went down to Egypt and sojourned there. It says, for famine was very grievous in the land. Last week I began to talk about how Abraham went to Gerar. This was the story of Abraham's journey to Gerar. The Bible says that Abraham, because of famine, he went down. Now, when Jesus gave a parable of the Good Samaritan, he said there was a certain man that went from Jerusalem down to Jericho. Anytime you leave Jerusalem, you go down. Is somebody here? So when the Bible says Abraham went down, it is very careful to let you know that this was an error that Abraham made. Is somebody with me? Please, you have to be, the Bible is very careful. Every word you find in the Bible is very, it is the life, it is the breath of God. Is somebody here? It is not as in, let us go down somewhere as in a journey. No, it is telling us. He said, Abraham went down to Egypt. Anytime you go to Egypt, you go down. What is Egypt? Egypt is a type of the world. So when you go to Egypt, you go down. That's why the Bible says when you go to Jerusalem, you go up to Jerusalem. Why? Because Jerusalem is a place of holiness. Egypt is a place of the world. You go down. But watch this. It was in this journey, in verse number 11, the Bible says, in verse 11, it said, and it came to pass that as he entered near Egypt, he said to Sarah, his wife, he said, you know you are a fair woman. Somebody here. He said, and the Egyptians are looking for fair women. We are going to pray. Are you somebody with me? And in verse number 12, he says, therefore, it shall come to pass when the Egyptians see you, they will kill me in order to take you to Pharaoh. Had Abraham not gone down, he never would have lost. It was by divine intervention that he was able to recover his wife. Because the Bible tells us that Abimelech the king took Sarah. Is somebody here? He said, and Abraham went to Gerar. And the Bible says, verse number 13. Bible says, he says, say you are my sister so that I can live. In verse 14, look at verse 14. And it came to pass that when Abraham was come to Egypt, they beheld her that she was fair. In verse 15, the Bible says, and the princes of Pharaoh saw her, and they commended her to Pharaoh, and the woman was taken to Pharaoh's house. Now, the prayer point I'm giving you here starts from verse number 10. He said, and there was famine in the land. It was famine that moved Abraham to Egypt. Say, oh, Pastor, what does this mean? Okay. If you turn to the book of Genesis, this same book of Genesis, if you look in chapter number 20, in chapter number 26, if you look in verse number 1, you will see something. 26 verse 1. He said, and there was what? Famine in the land beside the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went unto the king of Abimelech, the king of Philistines, unto Gerar. In verse number 2, look at verse number 2. He said, and there was famine in the land besides, in verse number 2 now. He said, and the Lord appeared to him and said, go not down to Egypt, but dwell here. The same famine that drove his father to Egypt, that same famine occurred again in the days of his son. Please follow me now. So that you can understand the prayer point I'm giving you now. That same problem that his father encountered, his son, after the death of his father, is encountering the same problem. And the same decision that his father took, his son is finding himself there. Look at this now. Look at this in verse number 3. In verse number 6. Go to verse number 6. He said, and Isaac dwelt in Gerar. In verse number 7, he says, and the men of that place asked him, and the men of the place asked him of his wife, and he said, she's my sister. For she feared to say she's my wife, lest they kill him. Is that not what the father went through? Are you with me? Is that not what the father went through? The same problem that the father encountered, now he's encountering it. You think it's over? Go to the book, the same book of Genesis, chapter 42, verse 1. In 42, verse 1, you will see something. The Bible says, and when Jacob saw that there was corn where? In Egypt. He said to his son, why are you looking at each other? Verse 2. He said, behold, I have heard that there is corn in Egypt. Go down. Same problem. Father, any problem my father experienced, any pattern of hardship, that my father suffered, that I am suffering today,
and I'm suffering today,
any pattern
pattern of hardship that my mother suffered, that I am suffering today. God of Apostle Suleman,
have mercy
and deliver me.
Have mercy and deliver me.
Have mercy and deliver me.
Have mercy and deliver me.
Open your mouth and cry.
Have mercy and deliver me in the name of Jesus. Adia so capando se predia zondafa. Iliando kosheble lito lia sambre dia sofa. Any pattern that my father told you through, that my mother went through. Wapuka tuza lantu sapradu ya zendaluche. Ayakaba sumpa tu adenua santia. Rakapantu libi kapali ya taboshe. Ayana dodo simbre dito fatose. Every pattern of
passion of tears.
Every pattern of
every
tears.
Every pattern of shame.
Every pattern of shame.
Every pattern of disappointment.
Every pattern of disappointment.
Every pattern of delay.
Every pattern of delay.
That my father suffered.
That my father
that
suffered.
That my mother suffered.
That my mother suffered.
That I am suffering
that
today.
That I am suffering today.
Oh God of Apostle Suleman.
Oh God of Apostle Suleman.
Have mercy and
have
deliver
mercy
me.
On me. Deliver me. Deliver me. Deliver me. Deliver me in the name of Jesus. Deliver me. Deliver me. Deliver me. Deliver me in the name of Jesus. Rika palababo shampo tiliata. Akoto didika dondi dika dondia. Epo sapusa prende kuselia luse. Atana mukusa prantuye deliaso. Atana masotia dotika pandoshe.
Rika po
dilibi panto yesuse.
Whatever my father suffered.
Whatever my father suffered.
I am suffering today.
And I'm suffering today.
Deliver me.
Deliver me. Deliver me. Deliver me. Oh God of my father. Deliver me. Whatever that my mother suffered that I'm suffering, deliver me. Whatever that my father suffered that I'm suffering, deliver me. Ipon Dalusha Kaisa Zuzale, Adana Masontia Tomoloshia, Akada Kada Kodo Kodo Kida Kada, Rapantoko Blandia Zonta Lufelushe,
Atanuka Pando.
Amen.
Please, please, I want you to pay attention.
Sir.
If somebody goes to the hospital today, and the person has a condition, before they give the person medication, they do what they call medical history. This thing you are suffering now, did your father suffer it? Uh-huh. We can see you have high blood pressure. Did your mother have high blood pressure? Am I talking here?
Yes, sir.
They call it a medical history, but we have a word for it. They call it pattern. It's not just a medical history, it's a satanic pattern. Talking here. Listen to me. You are going to pray this prayer. That it was an error for this man Abraham to go to Egypt. It was an error. There is no option in the world. Am I talking here?
Sir.
There is no option in Egypt. I don't know if you are here. But the Bible says Abraham went down to Egypt. In chapter number 26, verse number 1, look at this. The Bible says, when he came to the time of his son, he said in verse number 2, the Bible says, this same famine occurred in his day. He said it was the same famine that occurred in the days of his father. But in verse 2, the Lord appeared unto Isaac and said, don't go. I just get somebody a word now. A lady came to me 2 days ago and said, Pastor, I am in trouble. I am in financial crisis. He said, I want to go and borrow. I said, don't go to Egypt. Is somebody here? I just gave somebody a word now. Am I talking to somebody here?
Yes, sir.
Hey, don't go to Egypt. The God of your father, he may tarry. But what has been said concerning you,
yes, sir,
it will manifest.
Yes, man.
I said it will manifest.
Amen.
I said it will manifest.
Amen.
I said it will manifest.
Amen.
Look at the counsel of the enemy. The enemy was trying to push Isaac to Egypt so that he can suffer what his father suffered. Not knowing, only little did Isaac know. In verse number 3, God said, sojourn in this land. I know there is hardship now. I know there is famine now. But stay here. He said, I will be with you. Yamana, I will bless you. and your seed, and I will give you all these countries. But had Isaac gone to Egypt, he would have missed the miracle. Listen to me. I am an ashedia dada reba kotia sehe. The God of Apostle Suleman.
Yes, sir.
Hey, there is going to be a shocking miracle.
We receive.
The way things will change will shock you.
We receive it.
There is going to be a miracle transformation.
Oh, yes, we receive.
You will pray this prayer. Oh, God, prevent me.
Prevent me.
From making the mistakes my father made.
Mistakes my father made.
Listen to me. When you see a pattern, there is a familiar spirit. Every pattern is sponsored by a familiar spirit. The same devil that was fighting Isaac knew Abraham. The day he was born, even the day he died, knew him. Knew how to manipulate him. You are going to pray. The devil that Isaac was fighting now, it was the same devil that his father fought. Father, prevent me.
Prevent me.
From making the errors my father made.
Yes, sir.
Are you here? So that you will not have the same results they had. Lift up your hand. Shabbat. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
As I pray.
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 By your mercy.
By your mercy.
Prevent me.
Prevent me.
From making the errors.
From making the errors.
That my father's made.
That my father's made.
From making the errors.
From making the errors.
That my mother's made.
That my mother's made.
From making the errors.
From making the errors.
That others are making.
That my others are making.
By your mercy.
By your mercy.
I shall escape.
I shall escape
it. Your mouth and pray.
By your mercy,
God will deliver you.
I shall escape
it.
By your mercy,
you will not make a mistake.
You will not make a mistake. By your mercy, I shall prevail it. Ibon suprende lebo shanda la babosia. Iyo kosa delivery sandia.
You will not miss it. You will not be delayed.
You will not be delayed.
Whenever they missed it.
Whenever they missed
it. Miss it.
You will not
miss it.
You will not miss it. Whatever they derail, you will not derail.
Deliver me from
whatever
the
they delay, you will not be delayed. Deliver me from the errors of my mothers.
Deliver me.
Don't deliver me.
The same way.
You deliver me. Deliver me.
Do not let me go to Egypt.
Apoko shanto libi kabaluwa satiata. Ayabo shandi bosi bande bande. Arakabudi makasua taliatata. Rika panta lebekapa. Deliver me that I might not go to Egypt. Deliver me. I will not go to Egypt. I will not take the same path as my father took. I will not take the same path my mother took. In the name of Jesus.
Some of you don't understand the gravity of this prayer point. In chapter 42, verse 1, the Bible says this same famine occurred in the days of Jacob. But the Bible says Jacob went down to Egypt. He didn't come out until 430 years. How did Israel go into Egypt? They went to look for corn. How did they end up in the cohort of Pharaoh? They went to find corn. Hey, don't look for corn in Egypt. Listen, when I was small, we used to have, you know, they call it, I don't know what they call it here, but like basins, you know, like a pail, like a huge bucket. And then we put a little stick, you know, we turn the basin upside down and we put a little stick. And then we begin to put corn. We put corn, we put a trail of corn so that when the chickens, we put a little string on the stick. And we hide behind the fence. We stay there for a while. And here comes one excited chicken. He has found corn. Free corn. Oh! Others are looking for corn. This one just saw free corn. He's just eating. Doesn't know there is a trap in Egypt. He gets there and we pull the string and cover it. Somebody here. Listen to me. Had Israel waited, they never would have ended up in Egypt. Please, I don't know why I'm telling somebody this. Mm. Don't borrow. God will provide.
Amen.
Am I talking here?
Yes, sir.
Don't consider the option, because if you borrow, you will sit there for, you will increase the time you would have come out of debt. God will provide. Am I talking here? Listen to me. You are going to pray, because how did Isaac escape this trap? How? The Bible says he heard God. If you must escape the mistakes of your father, you must hear God.
Amen.
If you must escape the mistakes of your mothers, you must hear God.
Yes, sir.
A young man saw his father as he was growing up, living promiscuous. He was a very young man. I know him. He saw his father living promiscuous. And one day he said to his father, "Father, why are you doing this?" He said, "Son, when you grow up, you will know." The boy grew up, became a fornicator. Anything on skirt, he went after. Am I talking here? When he grew up, he knew. But it takes the grace of God for you to know it's not because you are fine. That is why they are just passing you. No. It's not because you are fine that everywhere you go, they are just asking for your number. No. That is how they did others in your family. But now you think it's because of the short skirt you are wearing. That anytime you go to the mall, just go to the mall, you must hear whistles behind you. It is the same errors that others made.
Pattern.
Somebody here. You listen to me. If you don't hear God, you will end up the same way, because this life, there is more to see than meet the eye. You need a hearing, my son. Don't go that way. My son, don't go this way. It was a manipulation that the enemy did. He created famine. To move, you know, sometimes you say, "Abraham, why did you go to Egypt?" He said, "I didn't have food to eat." Famine manipulated him to Egypt. Why would a man not pay tithe? Why? Because bills are piled up. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Bills are piled up. And now he says, let me just pay my tithe next week, next month. Let me just keep this one. You see, the devil has used famine to prevent him that month from paying tithe. And now he has eaten what is holy. And the Bible says it is a snare to eat what is holy. Are you following what I'm telling you?
Yes, sir.
Father, have mercy on me.
Have mercy on me.
Let my ears hear you. Don't let me make the same error others are making. The same errors that my forefathers made. The same errors that my mothers made. Lift up your hand of fire. Say, "My Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Have mercy on me.
Have mercy on me.
Every error my fathers
every
made.
Every error my fathers
every
made.
Every errors my mothers
every
made.
Every errors my mothers made.
Prevent me from
prevent
making.
Prevent me from making them.
Prevent me from the errors
prevent
of my fathers.
Errors
prevent
of my
me
fathers.
From the errors of my
preventing
mothers.
Preventing me.
Open your mouth, I pray.
Prevent me from making the errors of my fathers and my mothers in the name of Jesus. Prevent me, Lord. Prevent me. Ripando sobre ti azonda lashwa. Iko doni ni mikasi zini mikapa. Ayano. Ayano ni nini masuri. Yakozi ti azonda ni. Ipo na luasi ya telimia. Prevent me, Lord. Prevent me, Lord. Prevent me, Lord. Prevent me, Lord. Abayanko tosa brandu ya suza loshu. Prevent prevent me from going to Egypt. Prevent me from taking the same parties in the name of Jesus. Rika pana la basutia totai. Iko do 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 do. Prevent me, Lord. Prevent me, Lord. Prevent me, Lord. Prevent me, Lord. Ayakadoni mikasua patua teniata. Ripato zanua. 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 The name of Jesus.
Thanks, we bless you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father. Hey.